taking this opportunity to thank our principal, Father Santo Pullen, for setting high expectations for our students and educators. You have shaped the conditions for our teachers and students to learn and succeed. Dear Sister Lisa, our vice principal, we express our sincere thanks for all you do to improve our school. Without your impressive organization and incredible passion for the students, our community would not be what it is today. And our manager, Father Jubesh, we are continually impressed with your ability to unite our campus community. You have fostered a sense of support and appreciation that allows educators to improve their practice daily.
Hello my friends, how are you all doing? I hope all of you are doing fine and staying safe. It's been a while since I last saw you. So, exams are right around the corner, right? What are you all feeling about it? So a lot of my young friends have been telling me that their exams are soon going to start, that they don't remember anything what they studied, and they're getting very tensed. So are you also feeling the same? So today, let me tell you all on how to tackle these issues and also how to face exam without exam fear. Last 1 year has been so different and difficult, right? Different because we had online classes, and difficult because a lot of us had so many issues coping up with the online classes, because we had a lot of doubts and we couldn't clear it face to face with our teachers, and we missed our friends, we missed going to school, sitting in the classrooms, and a lot of it, right? But our wonderful teachers have done so much to help you all cope up with the situation. They have worked very, very hard the entire year to bring the best to all of you students. So, this exam, which is soon going to start, is to test what all you have learned in the past 1 year. And I also understand that most of y'all have so much of fear when you hear the word exams. So parents and teachers must ensure that they are teaching the students on how to manage the exam stress and also on how to face the exam without any fear. Now, let me tell you all how I faced my exams. Usually, when the exam time is approaching, many students feel like they're not hungry, they feel very thirsty, you feel like you're sweating very much, you'll feel like you're shivering, and so many things like that. But for me, when exam time was approaching, I used to always feel hungry. And my mom ensured that she was preparing my favorite dishes. And when I used to tell my dad that tomorrow I have exams and I'm feeling very tensed, he used to just say, "Hey man, be cool, it's going to be easy." The main reason that I could tackle all my exams without any stress were my parents and teachers. Their support was incredible. From LKG to post-graduation, finishing my studies with good marks and getting a good job wouldn't have been possible without the immense support from my parents and teachers. Now, all of us need to keep in mind something. Exams are not the end of the world. It is just a step that we need to clear in order to get promoted to the next grade, and which will test what all you have studied in the previous year. The marks you get today for your exam is for sure needed in future when you want to pursue your higher studies. It is very important too. But when it comes to a job purpose, not just the marks, but your performance and your confidence is also tested. Now, let's see how we can do well in exams and get a good score. Let me give you all a few tips. Let's come to the first one. Most of us have this habit of not sleeping the previous day of your exam and studying the entire night. Let me tell you all, this is not going to work. So all your exams are starting on March 8th, right? So you have around 10 days time. So you need to start preparing all your lessons in these 10 days. Always remember that the previous day of your exam is for revision and not to study any new lessons. The next effective tip I can give you all is, teach someone what you learned. For example, if you learned something new and if you're finding it difficult to remember, what you can do is, you can just go to your dad and mom and tell, "Mom, Dad, listen, let me teach you all something which I just learned." So just explain it to them and teach them that particular thing. By doing this, you are just revising that entire concept in your mind, and in turn, it is going to stay here. The next important point is, stop by-hearting and start understanding. Most of us have a habit of by-hearting the answers. By-hearting might help you unless and until you forget one word or two and you end up missing the entire answer. So instead, what you can do is spend some extra time to understand what you are learning. And if the same question comes for your exam, just write what you understood out of it in your own words. Believe me, this will work. Let's move on to the next point. Stop worrying and enjoy learning. We need to have interest and we have to love what we are doing. For example, if you are someone who doesn't like maths or science, you shouldn't always keep telling, "Oh God, I hate maths, I hate science. How am I even going to study this? How will I write my exams?" All these you have to keep aside from your mind. Rather, you need to start enjoying what you're doing. You need to show interest in that subject which you don't like, and in turn, you will see the difference and you will start understanding what you're studying and you will start developing the interest for that particular subject. The next point is collect your exam schedules in prior. So in some time, I will give you all your exam timetable and also I will be giving you all your syllabus too. So you yourself know what your strong subjects are and what your weak subjects are. You will be brilliant in maths, but maybe you're finding science difficult. So in this case, you need to allot some extra time for the subjects which you feel you are weak in. And the next point is, in maths and science, you will find that you have a lot of formulas which you need to keep in mind and also few theories and theorems. So what you can do is, take a sheet of paper and write down the formulas one by one in one, and in the other sheet for maths, just write down all the theorems or theories which you tend to forget. So right before your exam, you can just take the sheet of paper and just revise all the formulas at one go. You don't have to waste time the last moment by turning the pages of your textbook and searching where each one is written. I really hope that all these tips which I shared with you all is really helpful for you. Words cannot express how grateful we are to have Father Santo Pullin as our mentor, guide and support. Father has been our constant source of motivation during this time. Now we have Father Santo Pullin, principal of Pushpa High School, giving us his message.
इस सत्र के आखिरी समय पर पुष्पा स्कूल के प्राचार्य के रूप में मैं आप सभी को तहे दिल से धन्यवाद देना चाहूँगा. सभी शिक्षक शिक्षिकाएं, सभी स्टूडेंट्स और पेरेंट्स, आप लोगों ने हमें इस पैंडमिक COVID-19 के समय बहुत ही अनमोल, बहुत ही सहारनीय सपोर्ट दिया है. आपके सपोर्ट के लिए, आपके प्रेम के लिए और आपके सहयोग के लिए मैं स्कूल की तरफ से, मैनेजमेंट की तरफ से सभी पेरेंट्स को, स्टूडेंट्स को और सभी अधिकारियों को दिल से धन्यवाद अदा करते हैं. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट हैव बीन पास्ट इज पास्ट. नाउ वी नीड टू फोकस ऑन द फ्यूचर. व्हाट यू हैव लर्न्ड थ्रू आवर ओन सेल्फ स्टडी थ्रू द मीडियम ऑफ ऑनलाइन, वी नीड टू बिकम मोर कॉन्फिडेंट इन टू आवर स्टडीज एंड इन टू आवर कैरियर. Hope that the coming academic year will be more fruitful and effective through our classes. We are happy, or we are eagerly waiting for your presence in our Pushpa campus. Thank you and welcome.
We can't thank enough our parents and students for their cooperation during this past academic year. Nothing was easy at the start, but we have together passed this hurdle. On behalf of the entire management, all teaching and non-teaching staff, I am taking this opportunity to extend our heartfelt gratitude to all the parents who have been so supportive this past year. Next up, we have two of our students sharing their experiences about online classes.
Hello everyone, my name is Krati Srivastav. I am a student of Pushpa High School, Sarbani. Respected Father Santo, principal of our school, respected Sister Lisa, vice principal of our school, respected teachers and my dear friends. जैसे कि आप सभी जानते हैं कि 2020 कि इस पूरी दुनिया के लिए बड़ा ही घातक रहा है। कोरोना वायरस ने इस पूरी दुनिया को और विश्व को सभी को रोक ही दिया था। पूरे देश में स्कूल, कॉलेजेस, ऑफिस, मार्केट से सब कुछ बंद थे, जिसके कारण हम स्टूडेंट्स की पढ़ाई का बड़ा समस्या बन गई थी। हमारी पढ़ाई इसकी इस समस्या का निवारण करने के लिए हमारे विद्यालय के योग शिक्षकों ने हमें ऑनलाइन क्लासेस की सुविधा दी। शिक्षकों को इस योगदान में हमारी पढ़ाई की बड़ी समस्या का निवारण करने के लिए हम धन्यवाद देते हैं। हम छात्र छात्राएं आदरणीय फादर सेंटो, सिस्टर रीजा और सभी शिक्षकगणों को हृदय से धन्यवाद देते हैं।
हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज श्रेया, आई एम स्टूडेंट ऑफ पुष्पा हाई स्कूल सिलवानी। ड्यू टू दिस पैंडमिक लॉकडाउन इम्प्लीमेंटेड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड, ड्यूरिंग द लॉकडाउन एवरीथिंग इज क्लोज्ड, ऑल स्कूल्स एंड कॉलेजेस आर क्लोज्ड रिगार्डिंग सेफ्टी पर्पस। इट इज माय फर्स्ट एक्सपीरियंस when I am staying at home long time. So, school taking an initiative to conduct online classes by the teachers who teaches us very efficiently and clear our doubts. Online classes are very beneficial to us during this crisis. We get to learn the concepts as we just to learn the regular classroom. These online classes not only empower us with knowledge but also have to just to cope up with the advancement in the technology. Online classes are very beneficially school providing them. We learn to home. Thanks all to all management and all the teachers out the best knowledge to us and under this difficult situation. We all have to stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.
Thank you, students, for sharing your experiences with us. And thank you all for watching. In the next video, I will be giving you all your timetable, explaining to you all your syllabus. So please stay tuned for that. Thank you.